Spring Grand Pro brings pro wrestling back to the Lawford Theater at 225 West Main Street in Havana, Illinois on Saturday, the February the 21st for New Frontiers. See Jeremy Wyatt, Mark Sterling, Yabba the Clown, Marion Fontaine, Kyle Matthews, Mario Crivello, Blake Steele, and Ring of Honor top prospect Jake Durden. It all happens at the Lawford Theater on Saturday, February the 21st. Come here to the New Frontier of Proving Ground Pro in Havana.
Some legends are told, some turn to dust, turn to gold, but you will remember me, remember me for centuries. Just one mistake is all it will take, we'll go down in history, remember me for centuries. Hey, 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 remember me for centuries.
He is laying in the ring first from Palermo, Sicily. He is the Sicilian Psychopath, Tommaso Ciampa!
And this is a guy, Tommaso Ciampa, who I think a lot of people who pay attention to independent wrestling are calling as the winner here. They feel like he's done a lot of good things in 2014 after he came back from the ACL tear. 2015 could be his year. Keep in mind, too, he was ranked in the IPR 100, so had a great year. Kind of struggled a little bit at the end, but he still got a lot of momentum going into 2015.
This, I think, would have to be probably your number one seed in the overall Buckley Cup, like you're saying. ROH, Pro Wrestling Guerrilla, been overseas, Europe, Japan. Tommaso Ciampa's a done-it-all guy, knocking on the door of the serious, serious big time. Tommaso Ciampa is a man on the independent wrestling scene. And I'll tell you what, his second trip to the Proving Ground here, and he feels like he is primed to be the first winner of the Buckley Cup, and that may well be true. But I tell you what, it's not going to be a walk to the park, just like Ethan Page found out, just like Blake Steele found out. There's no free passes in the Buckley Cup, and this is exactly the reason why it's not a free pass.
This is a
Billy Squire in the background. That can only mean one thing, Travis Desmond. PGP's current reigning cutting edge champion, Mario Andrew Crivello, is making his way to the ring.
And it's interesting because a lot of people are kind of counting out Mario. Look at all the success he's had in PGP. How can you really count against him after the year he had in 2014? Yeah, he's not the indie darling. He's more of a Midwest guy. But what has he done at PGP? He has dominated over the last few months, especially.
He is a man that takes opportunity and knows how to grab it. He's got a solid mat game, but he's also mastered the psychology of the ring game, Travis.
He knows how to get into his opponent's head, that's for sure. He knows how to get into the fan's head. And just like our last matchup between Ethan Page and Malachi Matthews, the crowd will not be split here. Solidly behind Ciampa.
Oh, that's not going to sit well with Crivello when he sees Ciampa holding that Proving Ground Pro cutting edge belt.
He is going to be irate. And there he is right now.
Oh, what a show of disrespect from Ciampa. Wow, talk about lighting a fire under a guy. I guess Tommaso Ciampa wants all of Mario Crivello tonight.
He's going to bring it to, I think maybe he's trying to get in his head now. We talked about the man games from Mario, but what about all the things that Ciampa's done? Think about all the people he's worked with. He's picked up a thing or two, and I believe these two have been in the ring together before. Not sure if they've had a one-on-one match, though.
Well, Mario's a guy that's pretty much done it all in the Milwaukee area, whether it's ICW or Bruce City or Great Lakes. A number of promotions up there. He's a main eventer, title holder, worked a ton of quality competition. But geographically, I guess you'd say he was kind of stuck in that area. It's a quality area, quality opponents, but his name was not getting out there to the bigger indie wrestling audience in the country. I think the fact that he's gotten in the car, started to drive those miles, arrived in the proving ground, I think it's done a lot for Mario Crivello.
I think Mario's going to feel a little bit disrespected coming into this, too. You know, everybody's picking Tommaso. To be honest with you, I picked him, too. But if he heard that, that's just going to motivate him more. And the way Tommaso's acted so far, he's lighting a fire under his butt right now.
Absolutely mocking the amazingly egotistical and cocky Crivello.
But again, maybe Tommaso's trying to focus Mario and keep him from pulling the tricks that he usually likes to pull to retain that title. Again, the title's not on the line here. He doesn't have the full bag of tricks that he usually has at his disposal.
Well, I'll tell you what. This is a nice little role reversal, you might say, because Crivello is used to being the guy that's playing the mind games. But Mario is finding out that Tommaso's more than willing to go tit for tat, and I don't even know what tat is, with the mind games, Travis.
Well, you know, Mario's title is not on the line here. We talked about that, but you got to figure if Ciampa can beat him, that pushes him to the front of the ladder he could have two title opportunities. He beats Mario here. He wins the whole tournament. There's two title opportunities in his future.
Yeah, I would say the door would be wide open in the proving ground. It'd be hard to turn Tommaso Ciampa away. It'd be hard to say you don't have another. Now, he came up short in one of our best matches against Rough Crossing, and Rough Crossing with a lariat, I mean a lariat from hell out of nowhere, just managed to take that match home in Havana, Illinois. But that was for the title, and he came within an eyelash of winning it. And I tell you what, you're right. If he takes that Buckley Cup home tonight, it would be hard to say that he does not deserve a shot against Jake Durden, who we'll see later tonight in an amazing match.
But well, if Mario wins this whole thing, there is going to be no shutting him up.
Oh,
you know,
my
he's got
Lord.
That title. He wins this. He's in line for another title shot. I mean, seriously, the guy's just going to be incorrigible.
Well, this is the opportunity of a lifetime for a guy like Mario Crivello, because like you say, kind of geographically known as a Wisconsin guy, mostly, not until recently, a win over a guy like Tommaso Ciampa would really elevate the status of Crivello. But right now, Ciampa's continuing to clown Crivello.
You know, again, Crivello's being disrespected here. I'm not sitting here saying he can trade with Ciampa, but at the end of the day, you know, you don't want to disrespect a guy like that, but I think it's part of his game plan, what he's trying to do. I don't think he's taking him lightly at all, but he better not.
Honestly, I'm going to tell you right now, I think the way Tommaso Ciampa is approaching this match, he studied Crivello. He knows the mind games that Crivello likes to play, and he's trying to beat him to the punch on those.
And he knows him. I mean, he knows him. He's seen him. But, you know, who do you think is more motivated in this tournament? Because you figure Mario has his fallback. He has that title. Now, granted, he always wants the glory, but Tommaso, what does he have going for him right now other than being the, you know, kind of like Ethan Page, the indie darling out there? He needs something to hang his hat on right now. And what better thing than this?
Oh, this would be one more addition to the accolades he's been collecting across the country and around the world. One more fantastic little addition to the Tommaso Ciampa trophy case at home. And look at Tommaso. Now he's working on winning over those fans in Litchfield, which is a little unusual because I'm not. Wait a minute. He's going to try to pick up this turtle also.
I think it's going to happen.
A little short. I think he needs some help. There we go.
Fair enough. I will take it.
Well, I'll tell you what. He's a little more respectful of the BGP crowd than he was in Havana, Illinois.
I think getting in there with Mario kind of changes your perspective. I think even Ethan Page would have had a different perspective. But maybe it'll happen if they get into the finals together.
Oh, Mario Crivello, he's not just he's not what you would call a heel. I would call
him
a villain.
Yeah, and we talked about that, and I agree 100%. You can call him a 70s-style villain. You can call him a video game villain. You can call him a movie villain. But he is a villain. That is the word to describe him.
And there is all things possible that we will see him moving on in this match, because like I said, he knows every trick in the book. And I probably Tommaso Ciampa may well be aware of that fact, because he, you know, judging from his tactics, he studied Crivello. I think he's a student of this game.
He is in his head.
I think part of his success, and I think tonight is no exception.
Mario hasn't even taken a lot of punishment yet, and he's beat red. That tells you a little bit about his mind state right now going into a match with Tommaso. Look what Tommaso's doing to him right now.
Oh,
it's not that he's abusing him, beating on him. He hasn't had to do that. He's just getting in his head.
He is throwing Crivello completely off his game tonight. There's going to be no getting the crowd behind you, Mario Crivello. That's never happened for you in the Proving Ground.
I don't know that it's happened anywhere, to be quite honest with you. He's kind of universally despised across Wisconsin, Minnesota, all those places, and now here in Illinois.
Oh.
I think he has taken exception to the way he treated him.
Oh, he put a finger in the wrong chest there, my friend.
Yes, he did. They call him the Sicilian Psychopath.
He did not learn his lesson.
And he is living up to the moniker.
Oh, no, and Crivello's in a world of trouble here.
Can't do a whole lot with broken
fingers.
Oh, and
the toes, too. Oh, my Lord, Crivello's in a world of hurt.
Uh-oh, he better protect his face. I thought we were going to have our second busted nose tonight.
Wow, what a timely escape by Crivello. Rolls out in the nick of time there.
Mario's not looking behind him, though. He better turn around.
What?
Oh, there
he
goes his chest.
But what a bad timing for that. Huge chop to the chest.
If he wasn't beat red before, he is now. And he's going to show it to the Indy Power Rankings guys over there. What a chop.
Chris Mugg and a handful of
They
Mario
got a little bit
Crivello.
Of Mario in their life. Mario's in deep trouble right now. Tommaso's having his way.
He's begging, but no, the begging does no good at all.
A little bit of fan participation here at PGP. You got to love how the fans can get involved. They got to interact one-on-one with Mr. Super Mario there.
And he crotches
him on the post.
Drop, but it was even worse.
Oh, the back chop. The back chop. Insult to injury.
I've never seen Crivello in more trouble, Travis Desmond.
He better be happy that title is not on the line right now because it would be in jeopardy. But his chances in this tournament.
Jeopardy on the tournament. I'm going to tell you right now, Crivello is in trouble.
Oh, the savvy villain.
Man, did he need that.
Yes, he did. That was a desperation move.
Wow.
Not saying he didn't telegraph it, but that was a desperation
move
on the part.
That's like putting your hand in your pocket and finding that $5 you
didn't
know was there.
Not even a one count, though. Not even a one count. Wasted time. You know, Mario's going to really have to up his game here. He's not facing somebody who is not a legit contender here to win this tournament. This is one of the top names in independent wrestling right here. Mario's going to have to bring more than that to put him down for a three count, but it looks like he's going to all the cheap tricks in his bag.
It's no big stretch to say this could well be the biggest name that Mario Crivello could possibly, if he was to get a win, this would be probably the biggest name guy that he gained that win over.
Well, think about this. It would be a career win for him, but then he would have two more matches potentially in this tournament. Think about that. I mean, that is a high to a possible low. So, you know, again.
Penthouse to the outhouse could happen.
Keep that
focus. You just never know. Anything's possible tonight, Travis Desmond.
Three matches, one night, Saturday night here in Litchfield, Illinois, and this crowd is down with it. Come on, Tommaso. He is putting it to him.
He is absolutely choking out Mario. Mario's in a world of trouble.
Not a lot of love for Mario in this
moment. Oh, what a move.
After tactics like that, but then he just took his head off. He's gone to the eyes repeatedly in this match. Mario is getting a little desperate, I think, to gain an advantage time after time.
Well, he's no stranger to the chokehold, the eye rake, the low blow,
the pull of the tights, everything.
Mario's toolbox.
Yeah, for people familiar with him, you've seen him do it all to win a match. And he's going to need to do it all here, I think. I really do, because it's a hard matchup. But the funny thing is, Mario can go on his own without that stuff. That's just his style. I mean, that's what he likes to do. He likes to upset the fans. He revels in it.
That has been his game plan since day one of entering the Proving Ground. He's never been a guy to politic for popularity. He is all about the win any way he can get it, and all about Mario Andrew Crivello.
Mario trying to remove the mohawk of Tommaso Ciampa there. I don't think Tommaso took too kindly to that, and he's got him by the mustache. His pride and joy.
Oh, mohawk versus mustache. I don't know. I didn't know we were going to get that.
A mustache veal there. I can't say that I've ever seen that. And Tommaso takes a face full of turnbuckle.
Nice drop toe hold from Crivello to put
Crivello,
that.
Again, he's got all the tools if he chooses to use them, but most of the time he'd rather take shortcuts.
He knows
he's
how
going
to
for the count out win. A win is a win is a win. If he moves on by count out, it's a little tainted, but it is what it is. You move on.
Absolutely. And there's no shame in winning, my friend, especially as far as Crivello's concerned.
Yeah, he has no shame, period. I hesitate to say.
Oh, and a nice knee, but that 20 count's been broken and has to start over once again as our referee, Jason Pemberton, has his hands full here.
It was interesting hearing the words from both of these guys up on the YouTube before this match, and I think both of them feel like this is a huge match for different reasons here, and they're just bringing it right now.
Oh, what an elbow right to the temple of Crivello, and Ciampa just taking him on a tour of the community center.
Oh, and he gets thrown all the way to the back row.
Fans.
Tommaso back in solid control right now. He needs to get Mario in the ring, though. That's where he does his business. Tommaso making friends here at the Proving Ground.
I tell you what, he's on his best behavior here in Litchfield.
It's
a play. Oh, my God. He thought he was in control there.
Not Mario sure if he caught his shoulder or his face, but regardless, he is in pain right now. I think it was
his
face. There's
no give on those massive ring posts.
Mario's just going to taunt him here. I don't think that's a good decision, but a punch to the face.
No, I don't think he should waste any time in that ring right now. If you've got an advantage, you better press it on a guy like Ciampa.
And Ciampa is not, you know, anybody to take lightly. Obviously, we've talked about that in all the other matches. But Tommaso, if no one else, is the guy that you really need to look out for. And I think he's the guy that everybody's really gunning for in this tournament.
Well, sure, that's a feather you want to put in your cap if you're a guy on the indie circuit right now. That's a made man.
I mean, that is an addition to a resume, like I talked about earlier. Mario trying to negotiate. Tommaso just needs to tell him we don't negotiate with terrorists.
Knee. That's quite a thing. What in the hell is that tongue doing out, for God's sakes? Oh,
Tommaso's got him
God,
by the tongue!
Uh-oh. I've never been more
pleased. The knee!
I've never been happier with
and
Mario.
Again.
with Tommaso.
And again, there's three back
God,
to back to back.
What a lesson.
Cover. One, two. I was about to ring that bell.
God.
I thought it was over.
What
I
a
really
life
did.
Lesson for Crivello. Keep that tongue in your mouth.
I thought Mario was done there. I really did. He got popped. It just nailed three times in a row by Tommaso.
I can almost see the stars and little birds flying around
his
head.
I mean, he's kind of a cartoon character himself, so it makes sense.
Up and over, and a nice escape from Crivello, but...
Uh-oh, he's going to the ref.
Behind the ref's eyes.
Mario!
Had no way to see that.
And the DDT prevalent
this
again.
This may be all he needs to move on,
it
Travis.
Could be.
This is it.
I thought it was over again. I'm telling you, these guys are bringing everything they've got right now. And despite the despicable tactic by Mario, it was almost a DDT that put Tommaso down after a low blow.
Well, I tell you what, he's lucky that Mario didn't get the weight draped across that shoulder. Free, and it was easy to get up. But, man, I thought Tommaso was out of it on that.
Mario's deceptively big, too. If they stand toe-to-toe, Mario's not much smaller than Ciampa. That may do it!
Ciampa out of nowhere!
We've seen him put away people with this before. Is that going to do it?
I would
Cover.
Think.
He needs to hook that leg.
No,
oh, but
he
didn't
does it.
Need
that
to.
Was Project Ciampa, my friend, and Mario Crivello is out.
Here is your winner.
And Tommaso Ciampa moving on to the second round.
That match, you know, I think it was better than a lot of people expected out of Mario. I think that Mario really couldn't contend with Ciampa there, and he proved he could, but at the end of the day, Tommaso moves on, giving the props to the IPR guys. Tommaso, he's made a lot of friends tonight.
I tell you what, the Project Ciampa has taken down a lot of guys more famous than Mario Crivello, but there were several moments tonight, legitimate. Mario could have won that match. He was with an eyelash, but the experience of Ciampa turned out to be the difference maker, and he is moving on to the next round.
And I think Mario... Mario's going to be hurting tonight,
look,
but I'll tell you
what. That kid got a great picture with Ciampa.
That he did. Tommaso.
Making up for that rough treatment from earlier with all ego. Crivello may need some assistance in the back after Project Ciampa.
Yeah, he is, but he has his title to go to bed with tonight. So there is a, see, like I said.
That could help keep him warm on a cold January night at least.
Oh, yeah. And the snow and the ice storm is coming tomorrow. So he's going to have to spend a little bit of time recovering after that match. I think he took one of the worst beatings he's taken at the Proving Ground.